Experience the best of Philippines, the ultimate guide to visiting this beautiful country. Going to the Philippines can be intimidating, especially when you're first planning your trip. The multitude of choices and options can be overwhelming, but with careful planning, you can have an enjoyable and stress-free journey. With so many places to visit, it's hard to know where to start and how to make the most of your time. Time is precious, and you don't want to waste a single minute of your vacation. You want to make sure you get the best experiences out of your trip and don't miss out on any of the amazing sights and experiences that the Philippines has to offer. Must visit cities and activities to do in the Philippines. The Philippines is a fascinating country with a multitude of experiences to offer. This is why it's one of the most popular destinations for travelers around the world. From its stunning beaches and lush forests to bustling cities and ancient ruins, the Philippines offers something for everyone, making it a must-visit destination. If you're looking for the best cities to visit in the Philippines, Manila is a great place to start. The capital city is home to a vibrant culture, world-class shopping, and a variety of historical attractions. Manila is also known for its vibrant nightlife, with plenty of bars, clubs, and restaurants to explore. For a truly unique experience, head to Palawan. This beautiful island is home to some of the most stunning beaches in the world, along with a multitude of activities to enjoy. From snorkeling and scuba diving to exploring the stunning limestone formations, there's something for everyone in Palawan. If you're looking for a more laid-back experience, Cebu is the perfect place to visit. Cebu is an island paradise with white sand beaches, lush forests, and a variety of activities to enjoy. There's plenty of shopping and restaurants to explore, and the nightlife is vibrant and exciting. No matter where you decide to go in the Philippines, there's plenty of things to do, from hiking and mountain biking to kayaking and paddleboarding. The Philippines offers a variety of outdoor activities to enjoy. For a truly unique experience, head to the beaches to experience the stunning sunsets or explore the ancient ruins scattered around the country. Must try local cuisine and delicious treats around every corner. The Philippines is a food lover's paradise with a wide variety of local cuisine and delicious treats around every corner. Here are 5 must try local dishes from different restaurants and their approximate prices in Philippine pesos to US dollars. Adobo from Lola Adings. This classic dish is made with tender chicken or pork, cooked in a savory sauce of soy sauce, vinegar, and a blend of spices. It is served with steaming white rice. One serving costs around 150 Philippine pesos or 3 US dollars. Lechon from Cebu's Best Lechon. This famous dish is a whole roasted pig that is cooked to perfection and is known for its crispy skin and flavorful meat. A whole lechon can cost around 4,500 Philippine pesos or roughly 90 US dollars, depending on the size. Kare Kare from Cuisine ni Aling Sozing. This hearty stew is made with oxtail and vegetables simmered in a thick peanut sauce, and it is typically served with shrimp paste and bagoong, fermented fish paste, on the side. It costs around 250 Philippine pesos or 5 US dollars per serving. Tinigang na Hipon from Seafood Island. This traditional dish is a sour soup made with shrimp and vegetables in tamarind-based broth. It is typically served with steaming white rice. One serving costs around 200 Philippine pesos or 4 US dollars. Bicol Express from Manang's Kainan. This spicy dish is made with pork, coconut milk, and a variety of chili peppers, and it is typically served with steaming white rice. One serving costs around 180 Philippine pesos or $3.60. For desserts, you should try the Halo Halo from Razones of Guagua. It's a popular Filipino dessert that consists of shaved ice, condensed milk, and a variety of toppings such as fruits, beans, and ice cream. It costs around 60 Philippine pesos or $1.20 per serving. Another sweet treat to try is the turon from Tita's Kakanin, which is a banana roll wrap and spring roll wrapper. D. deep fried until golden brown and drizzled with caramel sauce. It costs around 20 Philippine pesos or around 40 cents per piece. Overall, the Philippines offers a wide variety of delicious and affordable local cuisine for foodies to enjoy. From adobo to lechon, there's something for everyone to savor. The above-mentioned restaurants offer some of the best local dishes that you can find in the Philippines, each with its unique taste and flavor. And for those with a sweet tooth, the halo-halo and turon are a must-try desserts that will surely satisfy your cravings. Whether you're a first-time visitor or a local, the Philippines is a culinary destination that should not be missed. So go ahead and indulge in the delicious food that the Philippines has to offer. You won't regret it. What are the best times to visit the Philippines to enjoy the best weather? The Philippines is a tropical country, which means that it experiences a hot, humid climate throughout the year. It is also divided into three main seasons: dry, wet, and cool. So, when is the best time to visit the Philippines to enjoy the best weather? The dry season, which is between the months of March and May, is the most popular time to visit the Philippines. During this time, the temperature is generally pleasant, with sunny days and minimal rainfall. It is the perfect time for outdoor activities, such as beach trips, island hopping, and hiking. The temperature usually ranges from 21 to 32 degrees Celsius, making it ideal for sightseeing and other leisure activities. The wet season from June to October is also considered as a good time to visit the Philippines. This season is characterized by frequent downpours and high humidity. The temperature remains between 22 and 33 degrees Celsius, with the occasional thunderstorm. Despite the rain, the country is still an ideal destination for water sports, cave explorations, and wildlife viewing. The cool season, between November and February, is the best time to visit the Philippines if you want to avoid the heat. During this time, the temperature is much cooler, ranging from 18 to 28 degrees Celsius. There is also less rainfall, making it a great period for outdoor activities such as swimming, snorkeling, and exploring the vast national parks. All in all, the best time to visit the Philippines depends on what kind of activities you want to do. If you want to enjoy the sunny days and the warm temperature, the dry season is the ideal time. But if you want to escape the heat and enjoy cooler temperatures, the cool season is the perfect time. No matter when you visit, you're sure to have an enjoyable experience in the Philippines, with its tropical climate and beautiful scenery. What you need to know about accommodations and transportation. When it comes to accommodations in the Philippines, there are many options to choose from. But Airbnb and VRBO are becoming increasingly popular choices for tourists looking for a more authentic and local experience. These vacation rental platforms offer a wide variety of properties, from budget-friendly apartments to luxurious villas. On Airbnb, you can find a variety of properties all over the Philippines, from bustling cities like Manila to tropical paradise islands like Boracay. For example, in the heart of Manila, you can find a cozy and affordable apartment for around $30 per night or more for a more luxurious option, a spacious villa with a private pool for around $150 per night. Similarly, VRBO also offers a wide range of properties, such as a beachfront bungalow in Palawan for around $100 per night or a hilltop villa in Cebu for around $250 per night. On the other hand, if you prefer more traditional accommodations, hotels are widely available in the Philippines, with prices ranging from $30 to $200 or more per night depending on the amenities and locations. When it comes to transportation in the Philippines, there are several options available to tourists. The most popular and convenient option is to fly into the country's main airport, Ninoy Aquino International Airport in Manila. Airfare prices vary depending on the time of year and the airline, but can typically be found for around $500 round trip for major cities in the U.S. Once you're in the Philippines, there are several options for getting around, including bus, jeepney, and tricycle. Buses are a popular option for long-distance travel and then can be found in most major cities and towns. They are relatively cheap, with prices ranging from $1 to $5 depending on the distance traveled, and they offer a comfortable and efficient way to get around. Jeepneys are a unique and iconic mode of transportation in the Philippines. They are essentially modified jeeps that have been converted into public transportation vehicles. They're inexpensive, with fares usually ranging from $0.25 to $1.50 and are a great way to experience the local culture. Tricycles are similar to jeepneys, but smaller and more suited for shorter distances. They're found in almost every town in the Philippines and are a good option for getting around in more rural areas or for short trips within a city. They're also relatively cheap, with fares usually ranging from 50 cents to $2. It's important to note that bus, jeepneys, and tricycles routes and schedules can be different depending on the location, and it's always best to ask locals or hotel staff for advice on the best way to get around. Additionally, if you're traveling with a lot of luggage or want more flexibility and comfort, you can also rent a car or hire a private driver. What are some pet-friendly places to stay in the Philippines? The Philippines is a pet-friendly destination with a variety of lodging options for travelers with furry companions. For those looking for pet-friendly accommodations, there are a number of hotels and resorts that welcome pets, including dog-friendly hotels. Some popular options include the Seda Hotel in Bonifacio Global City, which allows small dogs under 20 pounds for a fee of 2,500 Philippine pesos or $46 per night, and the Alta Vista de Boracay, a beachfront resort that allows dogs for a fee of 1,500 Philippine pesos or $28 per night. Another option for pet-friendly lodging in the Philippines is vacation rentals. There are a variety of vacation homes, apartments, and villas that are available for rent and that allow pets. For example, the pet-friendly villa in Tagaytay City, which can accommodate up to 6 guests and 2 pets for around $100 per night. For those looking for a more budget-friendly option, there are also a number of guest houses and hostels that are pet-friendly. For example, the pet-friendly guest house in Cebu City, which can accommodate up to 4 guests and 2 pets for around $20 per night. When it comes to prices, it varies depending on the location, type of accommodation, and the size of the pet. On average, pet-friendly accommodations in the Philippines can range from around $20 to $150 per night. It's always best to check with a specific property for their policies and fees regarding pets. I hope this video helped you give an idea of what it's like to visit the Philippines. Please don't forget to show your support and subscribe to this channel if you found a video to be enjoyable and helpful. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you won't miss on our next upload. I'll see you on our next video.